Hi there, I'm Alan Eaton. I'm an entomologist with UNH Cooperative Extension, and this presentation is about the impacts of UNH Cooperative Extension's Integrated Pest Management Program, the IPM Program in New Hampshire. Since 1978, we've been running this program, and we help farmers reduce their dependence on using chemical pesticides and save money. We teach people to manage pest problems by using a combination of tactics, to use preventative and suppressive measures, to monitor pest levels in the orchard or field or greenhouse, and apply controls only if they're really needed. Now, that last point may sound obvious to non-farmers, but this program began back in the 1970s because growers in this country were applying pesticides, farmers were applying pesticides automatically by the calendar, using them like chemical insurance, whether they really needed them or not. And as a result, pesticide use in the United States was going higher and higher and higher until this particular program began in every state in 1979, when they finally started going back down. Now, currently we work in fruit, we work in vegetables, ticks, field and forage crops, greenhouse crops, starting work on bed bugs. We write fact sheets and newsletters. We run grower workshops. We run a 24-hour fruit pest update telephone. We make farm visits. We monitor insect traps and we post videos. The work is largely funded by grants from the National Institute of Food and Agriculture and the New Hampshire Department of Agriculture, Markets, and Food. Results, and I'm going to look at 2013 because that's the most recent year for which we have completely compiled results. We helped growers that year in New Hampshire reduce their losses to spotted wing Drosophila by $987,000 compared to the damage in 2012. In apples in 2013, growers reduced spraying and at the same time reduced their pest injury, so they had higher quality fruit compared with IPM levels, by $110,000. Sweet corn growers did the same thing. They reduced their spraying, the ones participating in our program anyway, reduced their spraying by 2 applications per planting, and simultaneously they improved their crop quality. In other words, they stopped culling, throwing out caterpillar-infested ears, and that was worth $252,000 for the culling. In squash and pumpkins, reduced spraying totaled over $16,000. So all told, for a program that cost about $120,000 to $130,000 that year, we saved New Hampshire people $1.4 million. But beyond the numbers is the fact that growers changed their behavior, many of them permanently. And here's an example from the 2013 program, again, the cucurbit work. We interviewed the growers that participated at the end of the season, and we said to them, since we had these traps on your farm all summer long, did you change the way you managed squash insects as a result of that? And you can see 2/3 of them said, oh yeah, of course we did. And that's the point. We see many growers changing behavior, often permanently. In greenhouses, the number of growers that increase their use of biological controls instead of spraying is rising. And this has occurred because we were running the Tri-State Greenhouse IPM workshops that focused almost exclusively at the beginning, focused on using biological controls. So that number is going up higher and higher and higher. Reduced spraying has also increased the survival of beneficial arthropods like the syrphid fly larva feeding on green apple aphids in an orchard in New Hampshire. In the mid-1970s, many New Hampshire apple growers sprayed insecticides every year, sometimes several sprays, to control green apple aphid. But now, almost none of the New Hampshire apple growers do this. They let the predators, like this one right here, control the aphids for them. we increased the levels of one particular predator mite, this one's called Typhlodromus pyrae, by actually introducing a new strain of it to New Hampshire. And this one feeds on foliage feeding mites. Before we introduced this predaceous mite, most New Hampshire orchardists sprayed every year for the leaf feeding mites. And where this predator is established now, no spraying is required at all for mites. Reducing chemical pesticide use has also reduced the risk of contaminating our water, because when you reduce the number of sprays that you apply, this reduces the chance each time of having pesticide drift or pesticide leaching or translocation, and therefore contaminating our rivers or lakes or groundwater. Reduced spraying also reduces the risk of pesticide exposure for farmers and farm workers in New Hampshire. I have no idea how to put a dollar value on that. But there's still more. The savings have helped keep many farms in business during times of falling prices and foreign competition. We all benefit from having fresh local produce that is locally grown rather than sitting at the end of a very long food pipeline. Most consumers would prefer sweet, ripe, locally grown fruits and vegetables rather than hard, cardboard-flavored things that were shipped thousands of miles and bred to withstand shipping for thousands of miles. We benefit from having local farms keeping land open and preserving our wonderful views. And we benefit from having places where not only we can buy local products, like at this particular pick-your-own farm, but see them being raised and show our children how we do that. It's more than dollars and cents. So this has been a quick look at what we do. I hope you enjoyed it. This is a quick look at the people responsible, especially those of us who are on the fruit and vegetable IPM team. I hope you found it interesting. Thanks for watching and listening. So long.